Hi, I'm Rene Godefroy, and this video is about inclusion. So what is inclusion? And I'm talking about inclusion in the workplace, or inclusion anywhere for that matter. What is it? Inclusion is embracing others who don't look like you, who don't sound like you, who are not from the same culture, who are not from the same country. It's actually to be open to hear their ideas, to hear their feedback. It's to involve them so that they feel like a sense of belonging, like they belong. I never forgot when I first came to this great country, the United States, my accent a lot of time, and I still have an accent to this day, as you can hear my accent, but many people assumed that I was not intelligent, that I was not smart because of my accent. Basically, before they can even hear me out, they shut me off because of my accent. And sometimes I felt excluded many times in conversation, and I knew it was because of my accent. And so you don't want that to happen in your workplace, because your best ideas can come from anywhere in the company. It really doesn't matter. The best ideas are not reserved for the C-suite level. Here's why you need to have inclusion. You need to embrace inclusion. And I promise you, no matter how much you think you are including, there is inclusion in the workplace, you can always do better. Now, here's why. Have you ever heard that people say morale is low? Like I was reading an article and they say disengagement is a big problem in the workplace. People are totally disconnected and disengaged. And to me, part of the reason is because when people feel like they don't matter, when people feel like what they are saying, what they are contributing really are not being embraced, they can be disengaged, because they feel like they don't belong. By the way, of all the psychological needs that people have, according to Abraham Maslow's hierarchy of needs, people at the top is they need to belong. Yes, that's a huge need for people. When they feel like they don't belong, they are disconnected and morale can be low. And another need is love and connection. What happens then when you make them feel like whatever they contribute, whatever they share matters, now automatically they feel a sense of connection. They feel a sense of belonging. They feel a sense of love. Another one of the needs is the need to contribute. Yeah, contribution is big. Now, when you make your team members, and not just your team members, everybody in the company at every level, when you make them feel like what they are sharing matters and you are embracing them, you are accepting their ideas, their insights, they suddenly feel a sense of contribution. And I'm telling you, when people feel like they are contributing, they show up to work a different way. The morale is up and they feel upbeat and positive. Let me share this quick story with you. When I was a doorman at a hotel for many years, and I remember the salespeople, they would do their strategy session, how they're gonna go out in the field and make some sales and objections and all that. But what they often forget, that me, the doorman, and the bellman, we are the ambassadors of the hotel. We can literally kill a deal for them. And I remember in one instance that did happen. They had some visitor visiting the hotel as a possible site for the convention. And one of the bellmen, I don't know what he did, but part of it is because they didn't tell us. We didn't know what was happening, okay? And another time, there's the door, the front door, and people would just, for some reason, they would just walk into the doors because the door is clear and you would hear a noise. And I kept telling the bosses, the managers at the top, I just kept telling them, hey, we need to do something about these doors. We need to put some decals on the doors. Well, nobody paid attention to me. First of all, I'm Haitian. I have an accent. I'm a doorman. You notice sometimes when people are in uniform, they can be invisible. Like people don't see them, like they don't really matter. Well, guess what happened? One day a lady came and she walked through the glass door and I heard this bam noise. When I turned around, the lady, blood was gushing all over her dress. You can see her lipsticks in the glass and it was really bad. I had to call the managers, and to make a long story short, they ended up with a big lawsuit. And if they had listened to me, I just kept telling them, guess what? The next day, we had decals on all the doors. I don't know how much was the lawsuit, but it was pretty ugly. That's why we need to include everybody, because there are things that they see you don't see because they have different perspective. They have different backgrounds and different experiences. We can't just involve the people who grew up in the same environment, the same backgrounds and experiences. Chances are we are going to see things similarly. I mean, like they're not going to be the same things, but we are going to be so close to each other because we have the same backgrounds and experiences. That's why we need to involve people from different races and different background and different religion and all, so that we can have a big melting pot of ideas and information and insights. That's why you need more inclusion. And it really doesn't matter how much inclusion you have now in your workplace. I promise you, you still need more of that. The question is, how do you do that? Well, I want to share with you a simple solution. You want to install suggestion boxes all over the company, everywhere where the employees, the team members, everybody can see those suggestion boxes, and encourage everybody to share the feedback and put the suggestion in the box. And when that happens, I want you to also reward them. Yeah, pay them or do something, celebrate them because they are contributing, because they are giving you the feedback. Have some kind of award for the best feedback or insights or idea for the month. However you do it, you need to start right now to encourage everybody. Make them feel appreciated. Basically, that's what it is. When people are contributing, they feel appreciated. So here's what you need to do, all right? Just go right now, start installing boxes all over, suggestion or feedback boxes. Call a meeting with all the managers. Go to the C-suite. Okay, now this is something you can do on your, you don't need everybody there. Just go to the C-suite with all the top managers and then discuss how you are going to use the feedback and what kind of rewards and where you're going to install the boxes and all of that, so that you can have more inclusion. I'm telling you, once that happens, you will boost morale instantly. I mean, instantly. You will get people. You will meet how many needs at the same time? Like contribution, that's a need. That's a tight need. You need that. I need that. Everybody need a sense of contribution. Love and connection. Instantly, you will meet that need, okay? And a sense of belonging, that's a need. You will meet all those needs instantly by just having more inclusion, by just encouraging people to give feedback. Hope that helps. Have a good one.